congratulations on the film. It's surprised the hell out of me. Not that I was expecting it to be bad or anything.
Sure.
But how's it been for you? This is your directorial debut. What a debut. How has the whole experience been for you so far?
Thank you very much. Also, congratulations to you. I hear that I'm your first French Junket ever.
Yes, this is my
awesome
first interview,
for me to be
yeah.
a part of. We're both doing this for the first time.
Yeah,
I know. I mean, it was an incredible, it's been an incredible roller coaster over the last 6 months. I can't believe people like the movie. Well, I can, but at the same time, I can't because we made this movie with five people, you know, in a tiny
really?
Little edit
wow.
room
yeah.
for the course of 2 years with two iMac computers. So it was a micro indie movie. So for it to be seen in any sort of large scale is like mind blowing.
Pardon my pun here, but
yeah.
this turned out to be the movie that I didn't even know that I was searching for.
Well done.
It's really incredible. Because the found footage genre it in itself is still fairly new to the filmmaking world, and it hasn't really found its footing quite yet. The Paranormal Activity movies have kind of died off a little
mm-hmm.
bit. How did you want to take this subgenre and really make it your own?
Yeah, I mean, I think with any sort of... A found footage is basically a conceit-driven storyline. You're telling people how it's shot already based on the genre of the movie.
Yeah.
And with those kinds of films, it's very important that, at least in me and Sev's opinion, Sev is the co-writer and producer, that like the story has to come first, and it should feel like the form
yes.
is being dictated by the substance as opposed to the other way around.
Yeah.
So for us, like the big important challenge for us making a movie that took place on screens was actually trying to make people forget that what they were watching was on screens and just focus on a story. And to us, like if we could evolve found footage in a way that expanded its kind of language and to take place on screens, we would be doing something that was both new, but at the same time something very familiar and cinematic.
Yeah, I really gotta say though, I really gotta compliment you because I was expecting like jump scares and,
yeah.
and things like that, but you take a more dramatic approach.
Yeah. This is not
it's
a,
not a
boo kind of
it's
a film,
a
yeah.
film.
But it's scary in its implications, I think.
Yeah, I gotta say, this is one of the best twists. I won't give it away, but the twist was super solid because there was a moment in the film where I was just like, wait, this
that
is...
That doesn't add up,
that,
yeah.
That doesn't... It didn't feel right, and I was worried
yeah.
that the movie was about to end, but you... I was comparing this movie to Gone Girl.
Awesome.
I really... I feel like this is the best missing person thriller movie since Gone Girl. What inspired you to want to do this? What are some of your inspirations?
Gone Girl. I mean, we literally, when we were writing this film, Sev and I, we would literally spend 20 minutes at lunch every day watching a film that was influential or we wanted to learn from. Gone Girl was one of them. Prisoners was one of them. Ransom was one
great.
Of them. Mystic River. All these missing persons, kidnapped persons movies, abducted persons movies, all these kinds of mystery films and detective films, we watched and really tried to study what worked about them because there's so many great ones. And what we wanted our film to resemble mostly like a classic thriller as opposed to a kind of a gimmick film.
Yeah, yeah. This is your directorial debut.
Yeah.
How was it working with a few kind of seasoned actors? Because John Cho and Deborah Messing, they've been in this
yeah,
game
they know what they're doing.
For quite a while. How was it as a director directing these seasoned actors for the first time?
You know, I'm not going to lie. On the first couple of days, there was a lot of nerves and like self-conscious kind of voices in my head, you know, of like whenever I give them a note, I would walk back and be like, did I just say, what do they think of me? Like,
right,
did I say the
right
thing?
Okay.
You know, stuff. So, like, I think getting over that was a little bit of a challenge for me, but at the end of the day, they're collaborators. There's a reason why they're where they are and that they've been able to work with a lot of different types of people and succeed in many different environments, and I'm glad that we gave them, or I gave them an environment that they were able to succeed in.